cos ओमेगा टी का की। हेलो हेलो हेलो, हेलो हेलो।
यस सर,
तो नमित,
यस सर।
व्हाट डज दिस मीन?
सर, आई ट्राई टू फाइंड बट व्हाट आई गॉट वाज दैट इट इज सेम एज साइन ओमेगा टी बट इन कॉस इट इज शिफ्टेड बाय 90 डिग्री सर। ओनली डिफरेंस दैट इट इज शिफ्टेड बाय 90 डिग्री सर।
ओके, एनी आइडिया काकी काकी इमो? हेलो काकी, हेलो काकी, नेटवर्क नहीं तो दूर तेंजिन, एनी आइडिया व्हाट इज दिस? ओके 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 ओके, सो सेम थिंग यू हैव इज, सो दिस इज एक्चुअली द करेंट वेव फॉर्म विल स्टार्ट आफ्टर 90 डिग्री, मीन्स द वोल्टेज विल लीड। ओके, सो वोल्टेज अनलीड, सो पीक ना या आएगा, दैट इज व्हाट यू विल हैव। ओके, सो दिस इज द वर्ल्ड एस डब्ल्यू क्लोजेस एट द क्रीज ऑफ द अप्लाइड वोल्टेज, मीन्स दिस इज, मीन्स इट विल स्टार्ट कंडक्टिंग। सो दिस वन एक्चुअली the meaning of this is, so the current will start from this, so this current 90 degrees, so crest of this means this is the case. Okay, so now if you see during the positive half cycle, so IL alpha, so current in the inductor is given by what you have, current in the inductor is this, so IL is equal to 1 by L VDD. So this is the case, so in the circuit diagram, so which is equal to V, you can just replace this VT, this VT by this V cos omega T, and then you integrate it and then you see what you are getting. Okay, so the current waveform will actually start after pi by 2, means crest of that. This is the case. So now you will see is V by L cos omega T on integration, you are getting this. So after that you are getting this. So this is our final equation of current I. Okay, so IL alpha, so it has got two component, so this component, we have two component, first component is this and another one is Vm by sin alpha. So this, and this Vm by omega L sin omega T actually is called as a this sin alpha. This Vm by omega L sine alpha is called as offset. So this offset, which is actually shifted down for positive half cycle and shifted up for negative half cycle. So if you see in the figure here, here. So during positive half cycle, the offset is negative. So here it is shifted towards this. So this much is offset of V by Vm by sin omega L sin alpha. So this is your offset. And for negative half cycle, it is shifted towards upside, positive. So this is your another offset. Okay, so this is the offset you are having. So now see here what you said is, since by the definition it opens as the current reaches zero, equation 320 is only valid only for this angle, so between this equation is valid only up to this, not less than this. So then from equation 3.12, the term this V by sine alpha omega L, this Vm or V same thing we are having, so please check it and see baby, is alpha dependent, so sine alpha dependent, and therefore it is sinusoidal in nature. So this is the case where we have seen it. Okay, so that you can see. So you can go through it and figure the and it's just objective. Okay. So in short, what you have is like the whatever is written up there, in short, what you have is with increase in alpha firing angle or delay angle alpha, it will result in the increase of offset. Okay, so with increase in alpha, the offset, that is offset V by, or this offset Vm by XL sine alpha. The sine alpha will increase, which will result in the reduction of this conduction angle sigma. So this is your conduction angle. Conduction angle. So conduction angle. So this is your conduction angle. Okay, so conduction angle. So with the reduction of conduction angle, what will happen is IL, this IL is current through Katina, Namit, what is this IL? Hello, Namit.
Line current, sir.
Not line current. This is inductor current, IL. Current passing through inductor. Okay, so please check this. Inductor will increase. So this is how it will actually control the current, reactive current, inductor. Okay, so this is what actually it has. So with increase in alpha, so we will increase by giving the getting signal, gate signal to the thyristor or TCR. Na? Alpha, you increase the alpha. Okay, so this alpha you increase. With increase in alpha, what will happen is the offset that you have, no? This is there, and then you can have, this is alpha type. So this particular place we call it as offset. So this offset will increase with increase in this. So offset circuit diagram, no? We have, no? This is your voltage waveform, then current waveform will start from this. So this is your current waveform, and somewhere else here, this two is actually offset. So this offset, this is your offset. So with increase in alpha, this offset will increase, which results in the reduction of this conduction angle, which will ultimately reduce the current flowing through inductor. So if you want current to increase, then you have to decrease the firing angle alpha. So if you go back to that circuit diagram or that waveform, you can see. So this one. Alpha, the IL alpha is this. So this is actually nothing but this is offset. This is offset. Okay, so offset for positive half cycle, this is for negative half cycle, again, this one will be your offset. Okay, so that way you can have. So this is what actually is. So now here, what you are having is with increase in alpha. This offset will increase. Offset increases. But what you have is this sigma conduction angle decreases. So with this conduction angle decreases, this one will decrease now. this IN will decrease. Okay, with increase in alpha, IN will decrease. Therefore, the reactive power flowing in the, or reactive current flowing in the circuit will be decreased. Now, if you increase this alpha, what happen? Offset, if you decrease this alpha, offset will decrease. Then conduction angle will increase. And then this IL will also increase. So this is, so this is now, if you see the alpha or this current, inductor current IL, reactive current IL is inversely proportional to 1 by this alpha conduction angle. Okay, so this is what actually it means, short, no? And this circuit diagram, waveform and all this thing. So now if you see this case, so now if you see the whatever we have discussed here, it is short in mentioned in this graph, like waveform. When alpha is 0, see, this is the case. Now at alpha is equal to alpha 1, means we have increased to somewhere else, the current is decreasing. See this one. This is. Now second, again at alpha is equal to alpha 2, again the current has decreased. So the current is decreasing down somewhere else. Okay, so this. So like that, it is coming, and then finally you are getting is the oscillatory type. So damping now. So power damping you are. So this is when alpha, where this alpha one is greater than alpha one is smaller, this like this, it is alpha one is less than alpha two, less than alpha three, less than alpha four. So this, so as the angle increases, current decreases. Okay, so then it is get, you are getting is the damping out. So damping out the power, one function of that one. So this is what actually means. Is it okay? So in short, Nadi, this is how TCR actually controls the generation and the absorption of reactive power in transmission line. So this is here what you are having. See, the current in the reactor can be controlled from maximum. Is there when thyristor is closed, to zero when thyristor is open. So by increasing and decreasing the firing angle delay, you are actually controlling that. So the current control method for positive and negative half cycle is shown. So we have seen that. Okay, so that is the case you are having. So now if you can see, so now at alpha is equal to pi by 2, that is maximum delay angle, what will be the current, inductor current? Any idea, inductor current? Inductor current at alpha is equal to pi by 2, maximum delay angle. No? So any idea? Guy with you. Roshan? Hello, Roshan?
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you tell? At alpha is equal to pi by 2, what will be your inductor current? Okay, so this you can just see. Offset is maximum. Okay, so when offset is maximum, what will happen? Conduction angle is zero and reactor current will be zero. Okay, so in this case, see here, you can correlate with this equation, or you can correlate with this point. With increase in alpha, offset increases. Means when alpha becomes maximum, what will be your value of this? Actually, offset is nothing but offset you have is V sine V by omega n sine alpha. So the value of alpha here you have is pi by 2. So sine pi by 2 is how much? 1, no? So you are getting it. Then load current will be 0. So this is the case. The inductor will decrease, this conduction angle will decrease. So that is, it is becoming 0, and the reactor current will, so no current will flow. Means it is completely closed. Okay, so completely closed, the reactor switch is completely closed at this when alpha is at 90 degree. So that is means it is just starting. Voltage, so here. Here it is this. This is pi by 2. Now, as alpha increases, 120, what will happen? Then 160, 150, 180, then 360, what happens? So this is what it will go. Okay, so with this, as it increases, then offset increases, reduces, so and reduce to error, then it will be like this. Damping, so it will damp out finally. Okay, so the current or the current will be damped out. So now here you have two parameters, one is alpha and one is conduction, so they are actually covalent and therefore TCR is characterized by either of these, so you can use them. So here it does not absorb any reactive power. Okay, so no reactive power absorption taking place in this case. Okay, so here we have seen like in the like in this we have I have told you that it is used in damping purpose, so damp out. Okay, so where the reactor current together with spinal column are shown, so it was going, you know, that Yagian figure now, figure C now. So this is what you can see. So if you have seen this, the current was going like this, no? So starting from somewhere else here, maximum, then going minimum, it is coming like this. And then finally it will damp out. Okay, so Aniji, that is your damping purpose, semi-damping. Current is bigger. So here, alpha is max, alpha 90 degree, then alpha will keep increasing. Okay, so maximum alpha damage. Another function is it also dynamically controlled. So this one is used for controlling the reactive power in every cycle by changing alpha n, current comes out to be damping. So this current is coming out to be damping. Okay, so damping here. So the mathematical analysis of current profile you have is this. Yeah. Just you can see the Fourier expansion term, that you can have that Fourier expansion. Finally, you will get this part. Okay, so final, the fundamental component of inductor current you will get is this one. After expanding all this thing using the Fourier expansion and all this thing. So use this Fourier expansion and then you equate this one into zero and then just you expand this part, you will get this one. So now if you plot this versus the angle alpha, IL versus alpha, then you will get certain, so this graph. In per unit, so this you will get for LF alpha for this 1 minus 2 by pi and then for 1 minus 2. So if you plot this way, so here you can have this alpha in degree, then you can have this I fundamental inductor current fundamental of alpha. So when alpha is 0, what is your ILF alpha? So ILF alpha, we have two, no? Like this equation, this one. So V by Vm, 1 minus, when 0, this one will become 0. Then sine 2,0 is 1, no? 1 by pi. So that way you can go ahead and then you plot 1 by 1. So you'll get this. 1 minus 2 by pi, nadi, it is coming more or less straight line type. Okay, then LF kd, so if you use this whole formula, then you'll get this hyperbola. Okay, so this hyperbola, this is IF kd. 0, then you can have 30, 45, 60, you can go till 90 degree, then 60, and then you can have 90 degree. So when you plot it, you'll get some points here. So you plot it, and then you'll get this. Okay, so then from that above figure, we have seen that the DCR can be controlled. DCR can control the fundamental current from zero to maximum. So this one, you have admittance, no? In terms of admittance, you can. Okay, so please, this is. So again, another one, you have this. So with increase in alpha, TCR admittance, the thyristor control reactant admittance will be reduced from this equation, you can see, which results in the decrease in the fundamental current flowing in through the inductor. So in this case, power is absorbed, reactive power. So decrease in reactive power absorbed. Now when alpha decreases, reactive power absorption is increased. So two cases you can have that. Okay, so then so we'll stop here. Rest we'll do in the next class.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.